good evening. It's a pleasure to have with me a gentleman. I'm meeting for the first time, Ramas. And Ramas, I think we've been wanting to meet each other for a really, really long time, but it's been amazing to finally get a chance to meet him.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm going to kind of have Ramas talk about, you know, and it's unfortunate, but I'm going to be not so right to introduce him. So I want him to introduce himself really strongly. Years and years of experience, and, you know, fantastic. So how do you introduce yourself? Who are you, Ramas?
Okay, that's a trick question, actually, in a way. Yeah, as I said, my name is Ramas Swami Krishnan. My name has always been truncated into Ramas Krishnan for years now. By qualification, I'm an engineer MBA and a trained POC expert as well.
Okay.
And I've been into corporate experience for a little over 30 years.
Wow.
In India, in US, in UK, and then gave it up and sort of started off on my own. It's been now 8 years on my own. What I do is work with owner-managed businesses, like I like to call them.
Okay.
I don't like to call them SMEs because many of them are not really small, medium.
Right.
What's critical is the fact that they're owner-managed businesses.
Okay.
And I like to take them from point A to point B on a growth story. And we sort of work with them, engage with them, and work on a risk-reward model. So that's our passion, for helping other owner-managed businesses grow their businesses.
Fantastic. And let me ask you, so I think that's very... often not asked question, but, you know, I always try to ask this to every single entrepreneur that I meet.
Yep.
So what makes you wake up in the morning and do what you do? What's your why? You know, what's your why?
I think any entrepreneur will tell you this, I guess, is to make a difference.
Okay.
I think we all have a choice of making money, but the why is how we choose to make the money.
Okay.
So I think all of us have a choice on how we choose to make our money. So I guess I have my own way. How I want to choose my life. For me, it's about enabling others, helping others, consulting, growing. It's a great fun when you see what you do and you see it impact and make a difference to somebody else. And of course, you make money. But that's the whole story. So I guess it's just about making a difference.
Interesting. And, you know, I think Ramas comes with a very, very rich background. It's not mentioned. So go look at his LinkedIn profile. You'll probably see some stuff. But I think with huge experience with Ramco and then again being the with Siemens, you
absolutely
kind of started that POC practice.
Yeah.
For someone who doesn't understand theory of constraints at all, I mean, an entrepreneur, if he's seeing you, can you quickly tell him what's POC for him? I mean, what does that,
sure,
how can that impact his business?
I think the easiest way to talk about what POC is about giving a small story or an analogy.
Okay.
I think the most quoted analogy of theory of constraints is if you take a chain. Very often, we all know, and we call it a supply chain because it's made up of many links. Very often, we think of our business as a chain of many links, but in an additive manner.
Okay.
Which means, if you say, how do we improve profits? Do you say, you know what, I can actually increase sales or reduce costs.
Right.
So I believe that if I reduce costs in any of my functions, if I reduce costs in any of my departments, my profit will go up.
Right.
But any entrepreneur will tell you that's not the case.
Yeah.
If that were true, every of my team member would be saving costs every year and my profits would be doubling. It
right.
doesn't.
Absolutely.
Business doesn't follow the additive principle. So we are using the wrong measurement. So instead of looking at the weight of the chain, for example, which is additive, if you turn the measurement and look at the strength of the chain,
wow,
then the strength of the chain is not strength of link 1 plus strength of link 2 plus strength of link 3. The strength of the chain is equal to the weakest link. And if one link fails, the whole chain fails.
Right.
And an entrepreneur understands that. If only one department doesn't deliver, the business doesn't deliver. So theory of constraints is all about saying, you know what, you should know what is your weakest link. And if you work on it, you make a difference to the bottom line. Anything else that you do is a waste of time. And as owners, we're doing too many things at the same time, which do not really add up. So what we do as TOC is help the owner identify what are the one or two things to focus on, where if you make a difference, the business transforms. So that's probably the easiest way to explain what TOC is. But knowing where that weakest link is where I think it calls for a certain amount of understanding of the business. But once you know it, the difference comes very quickly.
So now you've been in business for what, about 7-8 years?
Yeah, about 8.5 years.
How many customers currently that you guys
We
service?
Worked with over about 80 customers in this last
Are you making, what's your retention rate on customers typically?
Oh, most customers work with us typically for 3, 4, 5 years.
Wow, that's
and
huge.
Yeah, that's long because we help them grow their business and growth is an ongoing story. And interestingly, right from day one, we followed some core principles, which is we work on a risk-reward model, which means as an entrepreneur, he or she is spending their own money.
Right.
Unlike a large corporate,
right,
somebody else's money. So we believe that if we are able to make a difference, we are able to show growth, we are able to make the owner more money, then we become a partner rather than a vendor.
Sure.
That's rule number one. Rule number two, we engage on a month-to-month basis. So there are no contracts long-term. And it's quite simple.
They can walk off any point they want to, whenever they don't see value. It's fantastic.
So if you don't, if you're not happy to see us the next month, we shouldn't be working with you. And incidentally, it's not just for the customer, it's great for us as well.
Absolutely.
Because we're wasting our time.
Absolutely.
So
right.
These principles help us have a very high retention ratio because we are almost partners in their business. So it really helps. It really helps.
So how does one, if you have to ask anything, if you have to help you, you know, if the whole world is watching, what kind of entrepreneurs are the right entrepreneurs for you to, for them to be talking to you?
It's simple. Progressive, growth-oriented owners.
Okay, if he's progressive, growth-oriented, he should actually get a chance to meet you and your team.
Absolutely. And simply because we are now talking about the recent concept, is as part of our growth story, and we are scaling up our business, and we've just tied up with a US-based organization called the Alternative Board.
Chip, you mentioned
and
that, yes.
Yes, and we're bringing them to India. That's actually a global forum of progressive, growth-oriented owners. And the whole idea of trying to bring the concept of a board of directors, which is prevalent for large corporates, to bring that board of directors concept to privately held enterprises and making owners accountable to their own goals is what drives me now. So
very nice.
My current focus in the next journey is to sort of implement that concept. So anybody who's interested in as a growth-oriented owner, I think, yeah, we should be talking.
Awesome. So the alternate board is something tapped. It's going to be something that you're going to hear much later, but just get a feel of it. Ramas is and the team are, they're the master franchise kind of owners for that in India, and I'm sure it's going to be an amazingly right thing to be working on. So let me few current Johar type questions for you. You know, few quick questions you can kind of, you know, answer. So how often do you change your, how often do you post on Facebook?
These are real trick questions.
Yeah, so how often?
I'm not on Facebook.
Oh geez, not on Facebook, okay. So,
so are you going to write me off?
No, I'm not going to write you off. So how often do you change your WhatsApp status?
Oh, that's like usually a couple of times a day.
Interesting. Couple of times a day, huh?
Yeah.
Interesting. So this gentleman is a WhatsApp guy. Changing is very, very interesting. Okay. You know, what's the last post that you did on Instagram, if you did any?
I'm again not on Instagram.
You're going to help him get on all of these. So if younger entrepreneurs looking, he needs to be on all of that. Are you on Twitter?
No.
Okay, so we need to help Ramas right away is what we realize, and you know,
I'm only on LinkedIn.
Okay.
And yeah, I'm on WhatsApp, and that's it.
Okay, so he's on LinkedIn and WhatsApp. So tell me quickly, what do you love about your teammates?
About my?
About your teammates, your colleagues.
Collaboration?
Yeah. What do they love about you?
They're usually worried about talking to me.
Really?
Yeah.
So there, is it intimidation?
No, I'm kidding. Not really. I think what they love about these ideas that we're able to sit together and come out with ideas.
Okay.
So positivity is something that I believe we've been talking.
But you're the man in control.
I'd like to say that. And like it said, I've got my team's permission to say so.
Awesome. Any last, this is your favorite joint. By the way, this is the T Villa Cafe. So if the T Villa Cafe team, at Chembur, if T Villa Cafe you guys are watching, trust me, this is few. This is a free video for you. Full on publicity. Great place to be. I think you use this extensively. Imagine a business owner of his caliber is sitting here using this extensively. Not because it's a great place to be. I think great ambience, great place. So T Villa Cafe, you know, we're not getting paid to do this, but trust us, you know, this is a great place. Ramas loves it.
Yeah.
And so one last two questions. I'm going to wrap it up real quick. How do you spend time with your family?
Oh, we would love short breaks.
Short breaks?
Yeah.
Favorite location?
Mahabaleshwar.
Last location that you went to?
Run of Kutch.
You did?
Yeah, interesting.
Favorite location outside the country, if at all?
UK.
Really? What part of
London.
UK? Cold
London.
Place?
London.
London?
London.
Okay, that's the great place. Tell me something about your family. You know, kids?
My wife is in Tanjore painting. She does the intricate gold Tanjore painting.
Wow.
Artist. She conducts workshop and she teaches people. She's a
right brain, left brain combination, huh?
Yeah, she is.
The logical and the creative. Wow,
absolutely.
Interesting.
She's a painting artist. She has her own website called artbylr.com.
This is called marketing, by the way. Selling
okay.
your wife very, very effectively. Can you repeat it?
It's artbylr. That is Lakshmi Ramaswamy.
Artbylr.com. Okay, we're going to go look at it. But yeah, that's very, very, very effective sales husband.
My two sons. My elder one is in the second year engineering. And the younger one is in ninth standard.
Again, engineering driven?
The elder one is, the younger one doesn't want to do anything with engineering. He wants to be a footballer when he grows up. So.
Interesting. It's been a pleasure to know and get some time to spend with you, Ramas. But I really look forward to kind of connecting with you all over again. And guys, if you're really looking at getting help, if you're suffering, Abhijit is not suffering. If you're a progressive oriented business owner looking for, if you have challenges, if you don't have challenges also, if you're progressive, this is the right place to talk. Get in touch and get in touch with us. We can connect you with Ramas as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Absolutely a pleasure.
Pleasure.
Cheers.